Well, it's like climbing a mountain, really, but there's no reason why we can come up here. Nobody really fancies us outside Highbury, so we can relax and enjoy the game and hopefully get the goals that we need. We had a tremendous first half of the season in Liverpool. They've had a tremendous run since January the 5th, I think it is. So, I mean, really, it's an ideal finale to the season. Number one and two going for the championship at Anfield. Tremendous.
It's going to be a cracking night, George.
I hope so. I hope football's going to be the winner, and hopefully we can get enough goals to get the result.
Philosophical, and what on earth would you expect? Well, the atmosphere here at Anfield tonight goes without saying. The fact the teams are still in the dressing room requires an explanation. The kick-off has been delayed for 10 minutes because coachloads of Arsenal fans have been stranded for hours on the M6, so the kick-off will be at 8:15. But the fans are on their way. The one thing I can tell you for sure, the championship will be decided once and for all tonight. Well, I suppose if you believe in happy endings, then the script has already been written and the championship trophy will stay here at Anfield for another year. Well, that's the obvious conclusion, that Liverpool will win the double, just as everyone said they would 12 months ago. The onus very much on Arsenal, but a 1-0 Wimbledon-style win is no good to them. They've got to win, and they've got to win well. Liverpool made it as difficult as possible when they turned over West Ham on Tuesday night, a match which epitomised Liverpool's completely professional approach to everything they do. Cutting loose with 10 minutes to go, scoring the goals, which makes it such a mammoth task for Arsenal tonight. Most teams would have settled for 2-1 on the night, but not Liverpool. 4-1 now, Barnes, a lucky deflection, 5-1. Well, some might say that Lady Luck has played a big part in Liverpool's unbeaten run, Bobby, since January the 1st, unbeaten since January the 1st. It's a remarkable run, and no mistake. Bobby Robson, the England manager, joining us tonight.
Thank you. Well, not luck, I think great team play, great desire to win the championship, great ambition within the club. Wonderful players, great stamina, you have to do that all the time to do the double, and I think they just deserve every credit that's been lodged upon them in these last 2 months.
But Arsenal aren't out of it.
Oh no, they have to win, and they know that, and they take a positive approach. The players know what they have to do. They've had more than a week to think about it. They won't sit back. It's lovely. Poised beautifully, if I may say so, because it gives Liverpool an even greater chance in many respects, because they have to attack of Arsenal and they have to leave themselves to some degree wide open, and they've got to get two goals. One goal isn't enough, so if they get ahead, which in a sense a lot of people here will hope will happen,
and which could give Liverpool the jitters.
Oh
that
yes
happens, eh?
The cat then really is amongst the pigeons. If Arsenal can score the first goal, Arsenal then have to even play even better to get the second goal. And to do that, you have to leave the door fractionally open. And that's when a team of Liverpool's class and individuality, you've just seen three goals there tonight, mm-hmm. where Horton and Barnes and Rush have the ability to dribble through the edge of the box, take people on and create things for themselves. Now, if Liverpool can do that, when Arsenal have thrown themselves at the defensive structure of Liverpool, then it gives Liverpool a chance as well. So it's beautifully poised.
Right, well, Liverpool and Arsenal have met four times already this season in the league and in the Littlewoods Cup, but the saga doesn't augur too well for Arsenal. They've yet to beat Liverpool.
Here's Barnes in the middle of space. Aldridge ahead of him. Rush inside him. Barnes might go all the way! It's in the back of the net! From Barnes!
Forward towards Smith. Thomas playing it to Rocastle.
It struck. Oh, a fabulous goal by Rocastle. And there indeed is the equaliser.
Forward now to Merson.
It's there! The last goal for Merson.
Oh, some delightful play there by Liverpool. Now McMahon. And some good tackling back by Michael Thomas for Arsenal. Stopped by Beardsley. Picked up by McMahon.
Long range shot! McMahon! 1-1!
Bennison to McMahon. Bennison again. Inside to Houghton. Oh, to Ray Houghton. A little toe poke by him. And it's in there by Aldridge. Here's Barnes skipping his way through. Stomping on the far side. Barnes with the shot. And at last the chance has been accepted. And Liverpool are in the lead. It'll come for Dixon. Real nip and tuck. Rocastle playing it in. Smith getting in there.
Tell you what, Bobby, they've produced some quality goals, haven't they, this season already?
Yes, they have indeed. And it's really a lot of what I've been saying. Again, great examples of individual player and imagination.
Yes.
People who can run past defenders, not afraid of it.
Most notably Barnes, of course.
Indeed, yes. But so can Houghton, so can Beasley. Rush can do it on pace. Aldridge is a good finisher. Drive from the midfield. In all honesty, they've got it in every department.
I tell you what, Bobby, there's an absolutely beautiful atmosphere building up here at the moment. I'm just looking at the cop over my left shoulder, and, you know, they possibly haven't done this for a few years. The scarves raised, the You'll Never Walk Alone, and it evokes memories of the great Anfield years under Bill Shankly and Bob Paisley. I think we're in for a very special night.
Yes,
tonight.
We are. And Ken and Dalglish, to follow on, you know, Bill Shankly and
I
Bob
think
Paisley.
He's reached the stature of Bill Shankly now, you know.
Yes, it wasn't easy. He must have pointed, I think, once or twice. But he's actually emulated him really in many respects. Possible double today. League champions last year, the double before that. Where does it end? And it only ends, you know, when the flow of great players don't come to Liverpool.
A ventriloquist, Bob. With a couple of monkeys on either hand. They are marvellous scenes, aren't they? Just on a serious note as well, The Anfield pitch is absolutely immaculate. Now, Arsenal's pitch isn't, and they've dropped 5 points from their last two home games. I just wonder whether they might go out there on that carpet there this evening and put on an exhibition,
and
you know, relieved to be away from Highbury and that quagmire.
Yes, in addition to dropping those 5 points just recently, they had a spell, you know, in midwinter when they picked up 6 points from six games, and there was a time when they lost the surface at Arsenal. It wasn't conducive to good football, and many of the players complained about it.
Well, Bobby, thanks very much. It's 100 years since English football produced an occasion such as this, the teams occupying first and second place in the Championship. Head-to-head, the last match of the season for the League Championship. The Anfield roar, welcoming and intimidating, as we join our commentary team of David Pleat and Brian Moore.
Thank you, Elton. Good evening, everybody. Arsenal on the pitch with bouquets of flowers, which I think in the first place they suggested they might pass on to the Liverpool players, but it was suggested by the club that it might be a much better gesture to take them to the crowd, which is what they're doing. And indeed, just before the start, the Arsenal chairman Peter Hill Wood presented a cheque for £25,000 from Arsenal to the Hillsborough Fund to the Liverpool chairman John Smith, so another fine gesture there. Let's have a look at the two teams. Liverpool with Bruce Grobbelaar in goal. Number two, Gary Ablett, who'll play centre-back. Number three, Steve Staunton, who returns after injury to the side at left-back. Number four is Steve Nicol, he'll be at right-back. Number five, Ronnie Whelan, the captain, with subtlety in midfield. And number six, Alan Hansen, recovered from a leg injury, another centre-back. Seven is Ray Houghton. Eight, John Aldridge, who scored in each of his last six games. Nine is Ian Rush. It means that Peter Beardsley is again a substitute. 10 is John Barnes. And 11, the man with the fierce competitive streak in midfield, Steve McMahon. Arsenal, meanwhile, with John Lukic in goal. Lee Dixon at right back wearing number two. At number three, Nigel Winterburn. Four is Michael Thomas, so strong in the midfield. And five, David O'Leary. 16 seasons at Arsenal, David's had, and never so close to a championship medal as this. Six, the young captain, Tony Adams. Seven, David Rocastle, scorer of a stunning goal here in the Littlewoods Cup, the man Liverpool will really fear. Number eight, Kevin Richardson, contesting that midfield.
9 is the top scorer with 24 goals, Alan Smith. 10 is Steve Bould. Now, a bit of a surprise on a night when you imagine that Arsenal must really attack, that a third centre-back, Steve, has been included. Number 11, Paul Merson. And the substitutes for Liverpool, Barry Venison and Peter Beardsley. For Arsenal, Perry Groves and Martin Hayes. Our referee tonight is David Hutchinson of Marcham in Oxfordshire. So, an immense task facing Arsenal. They've not won at Anfield since the season 74-75. Played 13 in that time, Liverpool have won 10. Ian Rush back wearing the number 9 shirt. And the manager who's in line, if they win tonight, to become the first manager ever to win the league and cup double twice. Liverpool's Kenny Dalglish looking very relaxed there. And a big surprise in the Dalglish family today. Kenny didn't know who the mascot was going to be, and it turns out to be his young son, Paul Dalglish. With the Liverpool skipper, Ronnie Whelan there. Both teams wearing black armbands tonight in memory of Stuart McIntyre, an Arsenal director who died today. And also, of course, football remembering that Don Revie, who died today as well. David Pleats, how do you think this one might go with the extra centre-back, which is a bit of a surprise from Arsenal's point of view?
Well, I think we've got the classic encounter today, the ultimate game, and I think what George Graham, who's in a most difficult position, he's got to be tight for at least half an hour, and at the same time he needs the goal lead before half-time. A very tricky one. He's going to push Dixon and Winterburn right in, and I would have thought they see Barnes as the main weapon, and that's why that Dixon's really going to push on down this right-hand side.
So a night of chilling simplicity about it, really. Arsenal must win by 2 goals to take the title. Anything less, and it stays on Merseyside with Liverpool. And Arsenal, in their change shirt of yellow, get the game underway, attacking the goal to our right. Just think, 10 months of struggle in all conditions since last August. And it's all on the last 90 minutes now. And the first time that our huge TV audience will actually see a title decided in the Football League. I just hope you're going to be comfortable there on the very edge of your seats for the next hour and a half or so. Free kick for Liverpool to be taken by Gary Ablett. As we've said, the task facing Arsenal, they've not won here since 74-75. They've lost on their last 7 visits. But the case for Arsenal is that they've got the best goal-scoring record in the First Division with 71 goals, and they are averaging 2 goals a game away from home, which is exactly what's required tonight. A night that will test the nerves of everyone here. And it'll be fierce, it'll be competitive, and it could be very, very skillful. A free kick given Liverpool's way. Clash between Bould and McMahon. Aldridge going forward. Ablett on the ball. Hansen, who came off at half-time against West Ham on Tuesday with a leg injury. It means a lot for Liverpool that he's recovered. Young Gary Ablett doesn't offer venture forward like this. Barnes, Liverpool looking very positive. The free kick, again apparently given against Bould for Liverpool, no matter than 7 or 8 yards outside the Arsenal penalty area, fairly central, and one would imagine the sort of situation that John Barnes might try to exploit. Lukic will need to line that wall perfectly. Staunton's behind it as well, Whelan as well, who's got a good record. I remember a marvellous goal he scored at Coventry from this sort of situation. but I think Barnes might well be the favourite, though Staunton's coming up, and in fact drives it straight through the wall, and Lukic was the one to gather. David?
With the insurance of O'Leary playing centrally, Bold and Adams will be able to get awfully tight to both Rush and Aldridge, and that resulted in that free kick there.
Rocastle, it came off Nicol, and Arsenal get a corner. Kevin Richardson will take it. O'Leary's gone to the near post. Arsenal's so good at these little flick-ons from the near post if the ball is served inaccurately, and that's what Richardson needs to do now. Bold is in there as well. There's the little flick-on by Steve Bold. Hansen struggling to get it away. Michael Thomas high over the Liverpool crossbar into that crowded court. Earlier this season, Arsenal, if they are looking for encouragement, came here, and Liverpool will admit it, that they outplayed them for most of a Littlewoods Cup tie, but had to be content with a 1-1 draw. Chris Bromelar. Dixon. Ablett versus Smith. Smith won that in the air. Whelan. Giving away the corner a moment ago, and a misplaced clearance there by Whelan. Is there a little bit of edginess in this early Liverpool play? O'Leary to Smith. Merson waiting to pounce. Nicol got the header in, and Whelan eventually got it back to Grobbelaar. That's a free kick.
As we thought, Brian, Winterburn and Dixon have pushed right in, and Houghton on the right-hand side, I'm sure, is going to be tracked by Winterburn right deep into his own territory.
But three centre-backs, O'Leary playing just behind them at the moment. There's one of them, Bold, with a header. Barnes. Richardson. Smith. Oh, another whistle. Awful lot of whistle, David, in the first few minutes of this game. Referee David Hutchinson no doubt seeking to impose his authority on the game, but at the moment it's not been given much of a chance. Free kick for Arsenal, David O'Leary with it. Towards Bold, who's right in there. Got his header in. Grobbelaar might have a lot of work to do in the air tonight. Aldridge finding Barnes. Rush, in fact, had just strayed offside. He was so alert that he flicked back quickly into an onside position. 11 goals, they're beginning to come back for Ian Rush. Liverpool seeking their championship for the 18th time. Won a free kick here, quickly taken by Houghton. Now Staunton. Crossing there again towards Rush. Hooked away by Richardson to Alan Smith. Thomas. Rocastle. Looked at the referee, claiming an obstruction caused by Staunton, but referee Hutchinson says no. Here's Hansen. Nicol, who's played just about everywhere along the back four and through the midfield this season for Liverpool, is Nicol, and has played in every game for them. Good jump by Adams. Arsenal coaches held up very badly on the motorways as they look round behind Lukic's goal now. The fans are still starting to dribble in, having had obviously a pretty horrendous journey up from London. They had a good police and referee and the clubs combined to delay the kickoff for 10 minutes. It's Nicol. A positive charge there by Adams, but it falls for Whelan.
I think Liverpool will have to be very wary about giving too many free kicks away. Arsenal have got some very big chaps in the side. They'll go up, Bold will go up for every free kick. He's already flicked on the corner, and it would be dangerous to give away too many, particularly early in the game.
Well, Bold is up there again. It's Merson on the far side that they're aiming for, but it was Bold's header here for Rowcastle, tangling with Whelan. Michael Thomas getting to the byline. This could be danger for Liverpool here. And it's flicked just wide, the header by Bold. Robinar, and Arsenal within a whisker of getting the goal they so desperately wanted early in this game. The big defender did so well there, and Liverpool's defence, not least Bruce Robinar, was struggling. It was a corner then for Arsenal. Bold again at that near post, looking for the flick in, and Arsenal may feel that this is where their best chance may come, but that was a corner driven in, and Liverpool grateful that Aldridge got his head to it.
It was a superb ball in by Michael Thomas there, chipped over Grobbelaar. A perfect ball for Bold.
Thomas now flicking another one in and getting his head to that one as well. Richardson with a back header. Liverpool under a bit of pressure here. Nicol getting it away. O'Leary returning it. Here's Barnes. Brought down by Thomas, and a free kick to Liverpool. Aldridge arguing with the referee a little too strongly. Liverpool get the free kick. Hansen floated towards Aldridge, got his header in. Dixon acrobatically getting that one away with his right boot. Richardson. Smith's touch will be picked up here by Whelan. Now Ablett to Staunton. Came off the Liverpool player, it'll be an Arsenal throw. 10 minutes gone, still no score in this crucial championship game, remembering that Arsenal need to win by a 2-goal margin to take the championship.
Started with no shortage of confidence, they seem the more relaxed side.
Well, George Graham was saying yesterday that nobody expects Arsenal to win, and so they can go and play a relaxed football. I don't think anybody quite believed him, because there is still so much at stake. But Arsenal have started well. Alan Smith on the far side, miscued. And again, Liverpool grateful to get it away. Nicol finding Houghton. Surging through from the midfield again. Rush has made a great run to the left. Thomas was getting back there. It comes through to McMahon again, and Lukic is down before Houghton can get in. Winterburn. Well, it came through to Michael Thomas. Picked up by Ablett, the flag waving on the far side, and offside against Merson. The game goes on. Liverpool firmly in control of the ball, so there was no point in the referee stopping. Well, that was a mistake by Richardson. It's conceded the free kick. That's where Rush does so much work in chasing back and hustling people, and Richardson underestimated him just for a moment there. Arsenal was struggling to get back into possession and conceded the free kick. McMahon allowing Staunton, the young Irishman, to take it. Whelan's up on the far side with Aldridge and Rush, and Houghton's in there too. Nichols made a run. Aldridge underneath this one. Person got it away. Smith's header. Languishing 19 points behind Arsenal in 8th position. They've had an astonishing run, unbeaten in their last 24. Offside against Lee Dixon, the fullback getting forward. And Arsenal, of course, their real problems came when they took only 1 point from their last two games at home against Derby County and against Wimbledon. By Thomas. Whelan finds Barnes. Winterburn. Rush getting there. Houghton trying to play it in, but hits bold with it. Winterburn looking to see what the options are. Smith galloping away. Ablett with him.
A super covering by Ablett. He'll be more than satisfied. He's had a super season. Both him and Staunton were loaned out to Bradford City and Hull City respectively earlier on, and it's done wonders for the confidence as they've come into this machine like Liverpool side and just taken to it like ducks to water. Terrific.
Hanson, the long ball forward towards John Aldridge. Bold held off him for a moment. That could have been dangerous, and Lukic is demanding an explanation. Extraordinary bit of play there by Steve Bold. And Lukic for a moment felt that he was grossly exposed there by the big defender. There you go, David.
Well, I think there'll always be a problem with
a little shove. There was a little shove on Bold by Aldridge. Yeah.
That's correct. And there's always going to be a problem. If the fullbacks are pushing well forward, they'll always be susceptible to that diagonal ball beyond the centre-backs, because the fullbacks can't get back to cover as well as in a normal formation.
Liverpool beaten here by 2 goals. It was in February 1986 when their old rivals Everton managed it. And a free kick to Liverpool. And on that occasion back in 1986, Arsenal's Kevin Richardson was in the Everton side that day. So he knows what it is to win here by 2 goals. Is it an experience that he will repeat tonight? In the meantime, it's a free kick. Hanson takes it. Adams, big and strong, right at the back, the last line for Arsenal. Ablett. Hanson. Trying to reach Rush. Bold getting it away, not very far. Houghton driving it in long after the whistle had gone.
One can't help feeling that Bold and Adams are going to give a lot of free kicks away tonight. Their job is to really be tight on Rush and on Aldridge. O'Leary will just sit behind them in that space. And as a result, a lot of balls played up to feet. There's going to be physical confrontations.
Smith, Merson in there. Thomas jumping and beating McMahon in the air for it. There was a foul by McMahon when the two men were in the air. A free kick to Arsenal. Well, Winterburn has got quite a dig on him. Rocastle might try something a little on the tricky side. Thomas is standing just off them. Richardson standing over the ball. So with about 17 minutes gone, can Arsenal find a breakthrough here that's so vital for them? Still 0-0 if you've just joined us. Match starting 10 minutes late. Thomas.
Given at McMahon, who seems to be everywhere in the midfield for Liverpool once again tonight. Winterburn getting in behind the defence this time. And his cross caught well by Grobbelaar. Adams. Foul there, Rocastle's boot too high on Staunton. In a genuine attempt for the ball, a free kick to Liverpool. Six times the champions in the 1980s. 1980, 82, 83, 84, 86 and 88. It's almost a case for the Monopolies Commission there. But Arsenal started brightly with a lot of confidence as Winterburn plays it forward again towards Merson. Up goes Richardson with Houghton, or rather with Whelan. And now here's Houghton. Merson. Picking out Bold. Again, Dixon's pushed right forward, as David was saying, both the fullbacks are pushing in. Merson looking for Smith. Again, the whistle is gone. The feet of Smith too high. A free kick once again to Liverpool. Hansen. Houghton. Nicol. To Lukic. Do you detect anything in Liverpool's style of play that's different at the moment, David?
I think they'll be quite happy at the moment, Liverpool. They've seen Arsenal's intention. They know how Arsenal intend playing. They're not going to change that until late in the game. And Liverpool are just beginning to stroke the ball around and work the ball from the back. And they'll be happy. They've felt their way a little bit, but they're now beginning to roll the ball around in their style that is so suited to them.
Lukic's long clearance. Merson apparently made a back for Nicol. A free kick to Liverpool. A game of stops and starts at the moment.
The game of stops and starts, and of course with Dixon being so tight on Barnes, it's going to be difficult at times for Liverpool to get the ball to him, and they want to get him to draw people by dribbling past defenders.
Here's Ablett again for Liverpool. 20 minutes of the game gone, still 0-0. Barnes. Aldridge tightly marked by David O'Leary. Staunton getting in, a flick on that time by Aldridge, but Rush won't be able to reach that. And Adams gets it back quite comfortably to John Lukic. Young captain, 22 years old, was a mere four-year-old lad when Arsenal last won the championship back in 1971. Arsenal looking to close that 18-year gap tonight. Aldridge, though, for Barnes. Richardson's head up. O'Leary, Aldridge to Rush. Oh, he almost got that in for Ray Houghton. But Nicol's with a bit of space here now on the far side for Liverpool. And made very little use of it, unlike him. Winterburn back.
Looks like being a midfield confrontation, Brian. Everyone is being tightly marked in there. There's not going to be a lot of wing play. It's going to be a very tight game in the middle. And it's up to McMahon and Whelan to manage to get balls off the Liverpool back four and make Liverpool play.
Thomas. To Dixon,
Thomas again. There's his cross once more, but Grobbelaar behind it. Smith couldn't get to it. And the throw releases Steve Nicol. In for Houghton, just busying that stride a little bit. That could be a Liverpool corner. Oh, it's a throw. Well, the Arsenal end looks pretty full now, so it could well be that all the coaches and trains have now arrived, and Arsenal have their full support. The throw taken, Rush galloping after it. Here's McMahon, sidestepping Thomas's challenge. Houghton. Little flick with the outside of the boot, Rush is after it, got there first before O'Leary and Adams. Played back for Houghton, and Barnes couldn't get to it because Dixon was forced to put it behind for the corner. That looked like a piece of genuine Liverpool attack, which brought them their first corner of the game. Whelan leaving it for McMahon, but Rocastle was in quickly for Arsenal. Now Winterburn, Richardson, Rocastle, and here's Barnes. Maybe a bit of space now to work a bit of magic. Rush, a flick on for Aldridge, and back again for Rush. Oh, driven with fantastic power there by Rush, but straight into the body of John Lukic. Real venom in that strike from Rush. A lovely little return ball played there by Aldridge. Hit with such power. Nicol. When he came back from Italy, Rush wasn't at all well, and then he had a hip injury. But really, you sense that over the last few weeks, he's getting back to the Rush that we knew so well before he went off to Juventus.
Just prior to that goal shot there of Rush, he made a superb run across the box to force the first corner when he played the ball back. A little deft run.
Here's Houghton. Houghton again. Took that nicely from Nicol. Tried to get Aldridge in. Arsenal were alert in defence, and now release Merson on the far side. Smith up alongside him. Rocastle's in there too. Thomas has made a great run also, but Staunton got it away for Liverpool. And now McMahon, and things beginning to open up a bit now. Houghton, still 0-0 on a night when Arsenal need a victory by two goals. Richardson, Smith. Just wondering actually whether, looking at Rush just a moment ago, he was shouting at the bench, whether he in fact jarred a leg with that tremendous shot of his just a moment ago. But Peter Beardsley is now warming up for Liverpool. And now Richardson for Arsenal. Ablett away. Winterburn. Again towards Smith. Well, it's tough if you lose a man of the calibre of Ian Rush this early in such a crucial game, a £3 million man, but when you can replace him with one that cost £1.9 million and a fully fledged England international as well, Peter Beardsley, that's not bad going. But Rush still there at the moment as Hansen comes forward. You can see they're continuing his warm-up. Barnes.
Just reflecting about Roche, the other number nine is also vitally important to Arsenal. They're trying to hit him with so many balls from defence, and his headwork and his ability to shield the ball is going to be so vital if Arsenal are going to be able to support and get efforts at Grobbelaar's goal.
Barnes to Staunton. Johansson. Whelan. To Nicol. Ablitz trying another route, finding McMahon, but difficult to find. Rush. Here's McMahon again. Nichols made a good break on the far side. Aldridge waiting in the middle. Rush has gone to join him. Barnes is in there as well as McMahon plays it in. Flattered away there by David O'Leary.
Liverpool are now finding that style that's been the hallmark of the play, passed to the nearest red shirt over the years. This play that Shankly began, and it's been fostered so brilliantly over the years. They're now beginning to play the ball neat and tidy, early and simple.
But losing it there, as Houghton is beaten by Winterburn. In goes McMahon. Oh, and McMahon surprised to get it back again. But must have been a foul on McMahon after that ball had been played. It's a free kick to Liverpool. Coming towards the half-hour mark, still Liverpool 0, Arsenal 0. Houghton taking the free kick, picked on by Aldridge, and a goal kick.
You can't help feeling watching Liverpool that their free kicks, their corners, almost instinctive. Players of the same mind, good players, but thinking intelligently. Arsenal, when they take corners, free kicks, you know it's been well worked. Each man has a particular move to make to try and get that perfect position to score from. And I do believe in that aspect. They happen to have missed Marwood considerably since his absence with injury. He's an excellent dead ball kicker.
Rocastle. Now Winterburn. Richardson. Merson. Nice little flick for the outside of the boot. Winterburn there. Richardson again. Two highly competitive characters, Winterburn and Richardson. Adams forced to readjust and being forced back by the running of Rush. Rocastle. Played on again there by Bowl to Smith. And now Dixon, the ball out of play. We've had just half an hour of the game now. And if you've just joined us, it's 0-0. And just to remind you that the match started 10 minutes late because of the hold up on the motorway that kept so many Arsenal fans, or at least made them late arriving here. See, they're still coming in dribs and drabs. It's Gary Ablitz. McMahon. O'Leary to Bowles. Richardson to O'Leary. The long ball forward again. Thank you, says Ablett. But he couldn't keep it in play, and so it's an Arsenal throw. Liverpool have been beaten twice at home this season. Should be some consolation for Arsenal looking for this win by Newcastle United and by Norwich City. Rocastle crossing it in. Ablitz getting it away, but only as far as Dixon. There was a shove on him by Barnes and a free kick for Arsenal. In the sort of position that will encourage the big men to come forward from the back and might just now put some pressure on this Liverpool defence. Winterburn, the man who will take the free kick. Adams, Bowles, Smith, O'Leary, all six-footers now, will be looking to get on the end of it. And in fact, it was flicked away there by Alan Smith. Liverpool about to make a substitution. Ian Rush sadly coming off. And Peter Beardsley is on. Well, 12 goals this season so far from Beardsley. And when he came on late in the game against West Ham, it was, on Tuesday night after West Ham had played so well for an hour, it was Beardsley who really turned the screw and provided the goals, or the means of getting the goals, in the last quarter of an hour.
My hunch is, Brian, that Beardsley might be more effective against the two centre-backs and the sweeper that Arsenal are employing at the moment. He might come into deeper positions and lead them into territory they don't want to get into.
Long clearance again by Lukic. There's Smith. And now Barnes. Looked for a moment as though he might be getting into trouble. Staunton got it away. Bold. A mistake there by O'Leary. Pounced on by Beardsley. Arsenal get a throw.
I think they've watered the pitch, you know, Brian. There's a couple of slippy patches and I think the players having a little bit of problems in adjusting at times.
Shot of the two Liverpool substitutes there. Harry Benison with Wanoe and Rush, of course, now off the field. The Peter Beardsley on it. Rocastle playing it in. Nicol getting it back with such confidence. And we understand that Ian Rush has a groin strain. And that will be bad news for Terry Yorath and for Wales, because Wales, of course, play West Germany in the World Cup at Cardiff next week. Beardsley up. Aldridge. Here's Hansen. Adams gets it back. Merson. To Richardson. Again, it's Richardson. Smith allowing Winterburn to get it onto the left boot. Was it onto the... Oh, he tried to get it onto the right, but then kicked away with the left for all that. Winterburn again. Away on the far side, gone past one, he's gone past two. Merson now finding Richardson, and his shot wide for Liverpool goal.
With Dixon pushing so far down the right hand side, Rocastle's been enabled to go and run through the middle of the field a little bit more and go and support Smith, and that's a little bit of a problem for Staunton at this moment.
Now Barnes, a slip by Lee Dixon, and one by Michael Thomas. No foul there on Houghton as Winterburn went charging into him. Not quite the flash points and not quite the atmosphere, and indeed not quite the excitement, I think, that we quite thought in the opening 36 minutes, David.
I think it's difficult because both sides, for the same ultimate reason but for different reasons in terms of getting the first goal, are very tense.
And here's Barnes. That was a trip on Bold by Beardsley. Richardson, flick through to Smith, and Richardson comes away hobbling after that challenge from Peter Beardsley, and suddenly Liverpool are free with Houghton and with Whelan running through the middle. The pass though held up, McMahon played behind him. Staunton. No foul. Thomas gets it away. Ablett, Nicol. Hansen. McMahon. Barnes. Maybe a
as you say, with the players so tense, I think that's transmitted itself to the crowd as well. Not quite as boisterous as you might expect. Barnes, the touch for Aldridge. Beardsley trying to get in. Dixon, Bold gets it back. Chased by Merson. Out of play, was it? Handball, the crowd on the far side were shouting. Linesman kept his flag down, though, and Arsenal have possession with Winterburn trying to plant it through for Smith. Instead, it's McMahon for Ablett. Liverpool seeking to open up the way on this side of the field now. Staunton finds McMahon. Staunton inside for Barnes. Houghton's made a little run for him. Here's Whelan. Tipped away by Lukic.
I'd like to see that again, Brian. I couldn't help thinking that Lukic made a bit of a meal of that one. It was a good shot, straightforward. Ah, maybe he was on the stretch.
It's a corner for Liverpool. Richardson being told to watch Beardsley by his skipper Tony Adams. But Beardsley finds it and then gets it back to Barnes. This could be a problem for Arsenal. Barnes seeking to get to that byline. It could still be a problem because the Liverpool get a corner. There's 6 minutes to go to half time. Barnes will take it. Aldridge, the look-alike for Ian Rush, waiting there in the penalty area. A deep one and flicked away well. Beardsley trying to turn it back. It was flicked away well there by Kevin Richardson for Arsenal.
You talk about the crowd not being so boisterous as normal, Brian. It's difficult for them too. They know a draw is good enough, and it's the strange result required tonight. They don't have to win it, but they want to win, of course, and they want to win so well to show everyone that the standards that they have here are the standards that we all must set ourselves.
Arsenal's throw. Dixon, and out for Rocastle, getting past Staunton, played in towards Smith, but again the red door closes tight. Ablett brings it away, and here's Barnes. Houghton, challenged from behind by Adams. Hansen. Away. They keep playing these long balls towards Alan Smith, but there seems to be no profit in them at the moment, David.
It's very difficult for him. Ablett's shadowing him all over the field, and Ablett's playing very well at the moment, and he's very bright, he's using the ball well. And Liverpool, really, they have command at the back, even though Arsenal are pumping one or two balls forwards to Smith. They haven't created a clear-cut chance apart from the early couple of crosses that were flicked on and Alan Smith's slight deflected header that went past the post.
Robinson. Ablett. Throw. And a Liverpool free kick. The championship will be decided on the night. Arsenal, remember, wanting those two goals. Victory by one goal, a Liverpool draw, a Liverpool victory means that that championship stays here on Merseyside.
There's Beardsley.
And you can just imagine the tension if Arsenal do manage to snatch a goal. In the meantime, it's Liverpool. A lovely little back heel by Beardsley. Now McMahon to Whelan. Nicol. Again Nicol, and again Whelan. Adams going across there. And cuts out the danger for Arsenal, but backs it straight and will touch off balance, and it'll be a throw to Liverpool.
He has his critics, Adams, but he's had a fine first half, and that's probably his first mistake.
Crowd pounced on it. The response comes from the Arsenal fans, who say there's only one Tony Adams.
Whelan, Beardsley.
In goes O'Leary quickly that time. Hansen now. Everybody now except Ablett and Grobbelaar pressed into the Arsenal half of the field. Here's McMahon, who's straight back into the Liverpool half, trying to get Staunton away. A lovely ball for Staunton, well taken by him, crossed in and cleared by Bold. Barnes, who's had a fairly muted game so far. Whelan. Hansen.
McMahon is starting to have an influence. I haven't had the good fortune to see Liverpool too much recently, but I know that he's up the gear in recent weeks and everyone's looking very closely at him at the moment. But he's beginning to get the mood of this game, and he's beginning to have a real influence now, and I feel that Liverpool are just beginning to up the gear.
But the mood of the game is still very much intact. There's still everything to play for. Remembering Arsenal need to win by two, but we come to an interval where it's Liverpool 0, Arsenal 0. We'll take a break, and after that, the views of Bobby Robson.
San Diego, 1988, the America's Cup. A head-to-head between the world's most advanced catamaran and the world's fastest monohull yacht. Stars and Stripes. The new winner, New Zealand. Hewlett-Packard, the possibility made reality.
Watch Queensway save you 10% on anything you like over £500 this weekend. Queensway is open bank holiday Monday.
If there's one thing guaranteed to upset a Frenchman, it's when something comes between him and Le Weekend. Especially when Le Weekend offers a certain je ne sais quoi. Fortunately, this Frenchman happens to drive an Audi 80, a performance car with a Mistral resistance factor of 0.29. And because time and tide wait for no man, the body is fully galvanized with a 10-year anti-corrosion warranty. The Audi 80. Vorsprung durch Technik, as they say on Mont Saint-Michel.
Something of no interest at all that you'll find absolutely riveting. Buy any Mitsubishi TV or video and Comet will give you 10 months credit. Interest free. You know where to come.
As our latest recruits, you'll be responsible for maintaining our reputation with the public. How good is that reputation? This good. We've been voted best car rental company every year for the past 6 years. We're now chosen by more people than any other car rental company in the UK. Why? Because we're the only company to guarantee service excellence. Because at Avis, every one of us tries harder. Thank you.
See the football on Thursday night, Roy?
No, I missed it.
Oh, this player was amazing.
Oh, yeah.
He's picked up the ball in his own half, right? He's dummied the centre-half, he's dribbled it through the midfield, he slipped it past the first defender, then the second, and then he's in the area on his own.
Well? Well, did he score?
Dunno. I came out for a pint of EP.
EP Best Bitter. From Eldridge Pope.
Welcome back. No goals here at Anfield, which of course will be good enough for Liverpool to win the championship, if indeed it stays like that. But Bobby Robson, our studio guest tonight, Arsenal's policy of playing a sweeper system, I mean, the match seems to be hinging on that one way or the other.
Yes, and the stalemate at the moment. I mean, Liverpool would be very delighted because they're achieving what they've set out to do, which is not lose. And Arsenal so far have got a long way to go. And I'm just wondering at what stage in the match now would George Graham decide to maybe disband it and play the extra man up, because there are times in Arsenal's attack when they are in fact one man short of in front. Now,
from Liverpool's point of view, how do you go about combating the sweeper system?
Well, several ways. I mean, first of all, long range shots is a good way, and you've seen Rush and you've seen Whelan hit two snorters, but two straight. Good flank play, of course. Ken Barnes and Houghton on flank seems do well. But the other thing I like is the angle ball, you know, the ball from right half, right across the sweeper.
Hansen's ball, that.
Yeah, that was Hansen's ball. That's the ball, you know, where you're putting the ball away from the sweeper and onto the second centre-half and hitting the space behind the second centre-half for the run. Now, Aldridge, in actual fact, had quite a good chance there. He'd lost his marker, the ball was an excellent ball, and had he just had a bit of patience on the ball, and let it just drop and hit it a little bit lower, that's a chance. But that angle ball from inside left to inside right, or from right half across to inside left, away from the sweeper, will beat the sweeper system.
There is a school of thought as well that if Liverpool are susceptible anywhere, if they do have an Achilles heel, it is to the high ball at the back. And there was an illustration of that early on when Michael Thomas got to the byline and pulled it back for Steve Bould, the extra big man, of course.
Yeah, well, that's right. And obviously, they have a lot of people in the air who are very good. And that was a close chance. Bould got up there very cleverly. I mean, it wasn't on a free kick scene. He crept up and relinquished his duties and got in a very good forward position. They've got to do more of that because they have to score twice. And unless they release players from the back, they're not going to make the opportunities to win this match.
Okay, Bob. Well, of course, Liverpool finished the first half with Peter Beardsley coming off the substitute bench and replacing Ian Rush, who was injured, a groin injury. Rush is down there now with Jim Rosenthal.
Ian, not the sort of game you really want to leave, is it?
No, it's very, you know, sickening, really, to miss a game like this. But it's how it's been going all season now, so at the end of the day, Peter's come on. I'm sure, you know, we've got another world-class player there.
You actually picked up your injury when you had that cracking shot, didn't you?
Yeah, I felt it a bit before, then had the shot. And when I had the shot, I felt it again, so really, If I'm not 100%, there's someone else on the bench who is 100%, I can do better.
That, of course, is the Liverpool way. You've just come out of the dressing room, haven't you, to talk to us, and we're grateful for that. What's the feeling in there?
Well, you know, with Arsenal, we're unlucky early on. They've had a really good one. I think it's a good game, but we're just holding them now, and hopefully, as the game goes on, I think the first 15 minutes will be vital, and I think after that, Arsenal got pushed forward more and hopefully leave more spaces at the back where hopefully we'll capitalise on them.
Very quickly, be okay for Wales and against West Germany next week?
Well, I think it's too early to say now. It hasn't gone completely, you know, it's a little twinge, like, and that made me not 100% fit. And as I said, you got Peter, who is 100% fit, and he can do a much better job than me.
Thanks for joining us, Ian. Let's get back to Elton.
Certainly, Terry York will have his fingers crossed. Well, we'll be talking to the England manager, Bobby Robson, again a little later on, but right now, it's another break.
What are these? Currants. Well, I know the currants, but what for and why used to come in your book? For some sort of project.
What sort of project?
Something like electricity. And will you stop asking me questions?
Mum know about this.
Of course she does.
Mum, Willie's sticking currants in your school book.
That's right. How's it going, Willie?
Okay.
Very good. But what about all the other things the electric people do? As well as making sure we have enough currents.
You think that those currents are electric, don't you?
They are.
No, they're not.
Why not?
Because you can't eat electric currants.
You're so bossy, you think you know everything.
Throughout England and Wales, there are 12 local businesses delivering the electric current we depend on for everything from streetlights to this television. One of them is your local electricity business.
Ancient Greece, where Homer sailed the Aegean and worshipped the gods. Now Sharon flies in from Luton and worships the sun. But if you're cooking in Greece this summer, a word about your plastic. Will it give you a certain kudos in Mykonos?
Λυπάμαι, δεν δεχόμαστε στην κάρτα.
Will it take you skiing in Skiathos?
Όχι, με συγχωρείτε, δεν δουλεύω με αυτή την κάρτα.
The fact is, Barclay card is welcome at thousands more places under the sun than certain charge cards I could mention. And now, the throwaway ending.
For details, dial 100 and ask for free phone Barclay card.
Panasonic have taken two hi-fi speakers this size and put them into a television this size. Result? Not only a television ready for Nikam digital stereo broadcasting, but television with an astonishing sound quality. Remarkable picture quality is thanks to Panasonic's advanced tube technology. Televisions that look and sound brilliant. Even if you're just watching paint dry. The Prism series from Panasonic. The state of the art.
Something's coming. I can feel it, and it's coming right around the corner at me.
Oh, sorry, old boy. Just digging a hole for me holster.
Interesting idea. How many are you taking out?
250 of the blighters.
250?
Yeah.
Anything I can do to help you out in the tunnel, just let me know.
What? Here's mud in your eye.
A Holston Pills production.
So, we're doing well.
But we're no doing great.
What this company needs is some...
Excuse me for interrupting. You mean...
That's the fella!
The Enterprise Initiative is open to all types of business. Take it before your competitors do. Phone 0800 500 200 for more information.
The lid is off the new Quartz Mammoth Superstore. Discover the fantastic choice of furniture, bedding, carpets and so much more at Hedge End Retail Park, Southampton. Now open.
And welcome back to Anfield. In the next 45 minutes, the championship of the First Division of the Barclays Football League will be decided. Ian Rush saying at half-time, the first 15 minutes of this second half could well be crucial. at Arsenal, you can be sure now, will be going searching even more diligently for that crucial opening goal. So Liverpool get us underway, now attacking the goal to our right. Staunton. Beardsley. Here's Nicol, an excellent first half, not least that clearance off the line from Bowles' header, playing it in again, but O'Leary putting it behind on the roof over the top for a Liverpool corner. Out and the little flick in there to Barnes. Liverpool will be looking to John Barnes to impose himself a little more in the second half, but he was unfortunate there with an outrageous bobble. And it'll be a throw to Arsenal. Winterburn, slight missed kick, but not won by O'Leary. Ablett, he's had an excellent game once more for Liverpool. Bowles just sticking out the foot and getting it to Dixon. Rowcastle. Is that a free kick for Arsenal? No, it's... Yes, it is a free kick. The shove in the back by Staunton on Rowcastle. Arsenal pushing ball forward again. O'Leary looking to hit. Alan Smith with it. Does so, but here's McMahon collecting once again for Liverpool. Nicol. Footballer of the Year, Steve Nicol, looking for a fantastic treble with the FA Cup win as well, and now hoping for a league championship medal too. Here's McMahon tangling there with Thomas. Play on, said the referee, nothing wrong there. McMahon didn't agree. They get it through to Rowcastle, a flick by him for Dixon. Can he keep it in play? He can't. George Gray and the Arsenal manager there wanting a bit more action and wanting those goals to come for Arsenal now. They need to win by two. Liverpool have conceded only two goals at home since January the 1st. That's in 15 hours of football. Now Arsenal have to achieve that in 45 minutes as Barnes takes up the running on the far side. Just keeps it in play. Beardsley and Aldridge waiting up there for the cross. But Barnes lost his footing and Dixon was able to play it back to his goalkeeper. So on goes Winterburn. Ball hit forward long again there. Thank you, says Hansen. Offside against Aldridge. First division championship will be decided. The balance has always been in Liverpool's favour, and the longer this second half goes on at 0-0, the more the balance will swing their way. Lukic with the free kick way outside his penalty area. Might come for Mercer. Caught on the volley. And a goal kick to Liverpool.
Scores goals equally well with both feet, Merson, and I just felt there when it dropped down. Okay, he went for his nearest foot, but I thought if he might have let it drop a little bit lower onto his left, he might have had a better opportunity.
Barnes, back by O'Leary. Already beginning to chant champions. It's a chant they know well. Winterburn. A deep, deep cross. Bowles was up there. Robillard missed that with his fist. And Liverpool breathed a sigh of relief as that one went to touch on the far side. Old trying to get in there again. Staunton away for Liverpool. Behind it for Liverpool. Rowcastle in there, Nicol away this time, and Beardsley. Adams getting in there. Arsenal pressing everybody forward now, looking for this breakthrough, and then the referee spots an infringement. It's a free kick to Liverpool, and away comes Hansen. Whelan.
Spaces they're likely to leave at the back, and I'm sure that Beardsley ferreting around as he is doing up front, he's working really hard, he's putting people under pressure, and I'm sure he's going to have a chance of capitalising on this space that's going to be left.
Dixon away, Alan Smith to Rowcastle. The sixth time these two sides have met this season, including the Mercantile Credit and the Littlewoods Cup. Arsenal have won one, Liverpool have won one, and three have been drawn. Still a draw here at the moment, but that'll be good enough for Liverpool with close on 6 minutes of the second half gone. 0-0. Gold gets it back. Whelan for his feet too high as he challenged David Rowcastle. Arsenal's free kick. Winterburn and Richardson behind it. Adams has made a darting little run in there, and Smith! Arsenal have scored. The Liverpool players are surrounding the referee, asking him to speak to a linesman.
The linesman never hesitated at all, Brian. I looked immediately towards the linesman.
Well, let's see here. Winterburn's kick and glanced in by Smith, but he's coming across to have a word with the linesman now. A crucial decision here. Well, Liverpool were claiming that Smith handled the ball. On the word of the linesman, so much will now depend. Ronnie Whelan looking on there. The goal's been given. And what a game we have now. A breakthrough by Arsenal, their fans are delighted. The Arsenal bench wonder what happens now. Flicked across there on the far side. It was touched in by Smith.
I can't see room for a genuine complaint there. He came in late, he got in on the blind side, and he definitely made his move after the ball was played.
So Alan Smith notches up his 25th goal of the season. And suddenly this league championship is on a knife edge. One more goal and Arsenal will win it. So Liverpool themselves have quite a task now. The Kop are encouraging their team.
It's that most dangerous ball when the left-footed ball going away from the defenders. A very difficult one for defenders to deal with. But Smith came in very late.
Difficult to see what the argument's about, David.
Well, I'm certain that wasn't offside.
So, O'Leary planting it forward.
Arsenal can sense a night of glory here now. Grobbelaar struggling, and Ablett forced into emergency action to get that one away.
This would be a time for
the goalkeeper under a lot of tension and pressure there now. Sorry, David.
Well, it's cool and calm.
Barnes needing to get it away, and Liverpool needing a goal to restore their confidence now. If it stays this way, Liverpool remain the champions. But if Arsenal get a second, they'll wrest that championship away from Merseyside and take it back to North London.
Liverpool more than ever now will need to get Barnes in the game and Houghton in the game on the other side and just take the sting out of the game. It's got a little bit emotional. Grobbelaar there's arguing with Ablett for that ball previously, and they just need to keep calm and start stroking the ball about in their style.
Staunton with the free kick for Liverpool, up towards Aldridge, beaten well in the air by Adams. In comes Thomas. Merson chasing after this one, but it'll beat them all into touch. Well, will the title slip away at the very last? Nobody gave them a chance at the beginning of March when there were 19 points adrift of Arsenal and lying eighth in the table. But coming to this game tonight, they were clear favourites. And they might still be favourites. I gather the Liverpool bench are claiming that the linesman that the referee discussed that situation with put his flag up and then put it down again. McMahon. And now Nicol. And now Houghton. Arsenal being forced back here. Beards is in behind them, but the flag is up for an offside on the far side. It'll be Arsenal's free kick. Terrific atmosphere now, which I'm sure you're savouring at home. And a lot of noise coming from the Arsenal end. Nicol, one of the coolest heads in the game, and he might well need it now. Gets it away under pressure from Merson. Arsenal's throw, looking for this second crucial goal now. Winterburn, whose free kick it was that led to the goal. There's Nicol. And now Winterburn again. Oh, he's dummied them, but he puts it behind.
It was interesting to hear Bobby Robson speaking at half-time about that diagonal ball. He mentioned right halves and inside lefts in old-fashioned terminology. And then now we have a game where Rocastle has pushed in, Merson's pushed in like old-fashioned inside forward supporting Smith. And Arsenal, in effect, have got no wingers, or they have wingers, if you count Dixon and Winterburn as wingers. But it's a fascinating game now.
Barnes leaping and winning it. Aldridge now telling Houghton to chase after this one, but Lukic, standing at 6'4", always had a chance against the 5'7" Ray Houghton. Thomas. Smith, it looked like a handball. The referee agreed. It's a free kick for Liverpool. But Arsenal know there's the scent of glory in the air. Liverpool will still take some beating. Barnes. Bold. Richardson. A real up and under. Both the main Arsenal strikers were up there looking for it. Merson and Smith. Nicol being forced to turn away and get it back to Bruce Grobbelaar. Grobbelaar, who's not been on the losing side for Arsenal this season. He played five at the start and then suffered a bout of meningitis and has played 21 games since January. Has never been on the losing side.
good job. Barnes turning it in very well. Whelan quick to pounce on it. Barnes once again playing an almost lazy ball in there. Flag up on the far side again for offside. The Liverpool fans behind the four linesmen on the far side shaking their fists. But it looked offside.
I should think the four linesmen must be feeling the pressure too, Brian. Everyone's feeling the pressure, but the referee can only be guided by linesmen. And to be fair with the goal, the referee came over, the Liverpool players got him to the linesman, and after discussion, he was quite happy to give the goal.
Nichols header. Beardsley. Houghton. Here's Bold. Well, Arsenal's goal has certainly made this a night of great possibilities now. And ball, say the Arsenal fans. Is it given? No, it's a throw. Lee Dixon will take it. Getting ready to launch a long one into that Liverpool penalty area. And to that end, David O'Leary has gone into the box, but he plays it short instead to Richardson. There's O'Leary. Beardsley trying to get a touch away there. Stopped by Michael Thomas. Played into space here for Rocastle on the far side. Smith's waiting in the middle and Merson's in there too. And in the end, Whelan gets it away. A foul on Aldridge. By Bold, a free kick to Liverpool.
I must say there looked a suspicion of offside in that Arsenal attack.
Just under half an hour to go. When the whole season of First Division football will be decided. Arsenal leading here by 1-0, but needing 2 to snatch the title. Winterburner. Merson charging after it, but the ball beats him into touch. It's a Liverpool throw. Balance there. Applet, Beardsley, O'Leary. The pressure those players are under now. One mistake, you can imagine the Liverpool defence letting Arsenal in for the title. One mistake in the Arsenal defence that suddenly makes it clear again for Liverpool. Playing under enormous pressure now. O'Leary.
I must say the midfield confrontation between Thomas and Richardson on behalf of Arsenal and Whelan and McMahon, the Arsenal players seem to have the more power at the moment. Whether it's the extra games that Liverpool have played after the euphoria of the cup win and the terrific result against West Ham, but they just seem a little bit jaded at the moment.
It's almost a mistake there by Hansen, and suddenly Richardson's in. A gobble out there. Whelan was back doing some excellent defensive covering for Liverpool. Well, Arsenal at the moment looking the stronger side. And the young Liverpool fans and the older ones too, just hoping that their side can get through the next 25 minutes or so unscathed. Robles clearance to the head of Barnes, to the feet of Beardsley. Beardsley again. Foul there by Dixon on Barnes, a free kick to Liverpool. Just when the Liverpool machine seemed to be moving into gear again. Barnes over the kick. Coming in at the far side. Okay.
I'd love to see Barnes really get into the game, or Liverpool get him into the game. There's the goal again. with Winterburn's ball. There, as he touches it, there's no one offside as he plays this ball. There it goes. It's slackness that's allowed Smith to creep in, and it's just the deftest of touches. Oh, to me, it's a classic goal.
And a crucial one. Winterburn, Merson, Richardson, Smith. Winterburn now. Here's Richardson, and moving with great confidence at the moment, Arsenal. But Liverpool get it back to Brotherhill. And the volume's been turned up as well. The Arsenal fans, you can probably hear them shouting, attack, 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 which is what their side has got to do, but at the same time, they've got to stay vigilant at the back. Smith, Rocastle, Richard, or rather Dixon. And the cross is wasted. It's a goal kick.
You know, the sweeper system in this country has a lot of critics for being defensive orientated, but there's no question about it. If the players approach it in a positive frame, then it can be most attractive, and it can be a really forward-looking system if you really get your fullbacks forward and attack. And certainly at the moment, Arsenal are playing the system really with attack in mind.
Too high for Beardsley. All right, David, where's your money now? With the, what, 25 minutes to go, 24 minutes to go?
I'd flip a coin, Brian. It's as close as that. I'd just like to see Barnes, he go wandering and pick up some balls and give Dixon a problem. He's staying out there on the left-hand side, and Dixon knows exactly what his situation is.
Here's Houghton. Adams coming across, though, and his long legs and his determination get in. Liverpool are stopped again. Kenny Dalglish returns to the bench disappointed, and his side get a throw to be taken by Steve Nicol. What they wouldn't give for another goal. Houghton. He's at the path of Merson. He's away again, and McMahon is after him. This is a great run by Merson. In the end, he took on too much, and Staunton was able to get it back. What a noise there is around Anfield now. Ablett. Back to Grobbelaar. Halfway through this second half. Barnes, Beardsley, Barnes, towards Aldridge, a flick on by him, towards Houghton. No foul. The Kop were howling for a penalty, but the referee didn't want to know about that one. Smith. Played into the path of Winterburn. Slips it for Thomas. Shakes off Whelan. But Houghton's in there too, and it runs through. No, it's a free kick for Liverpool. Rocastle arguing furiously with the referee over that one. Smith's goal really lit the blue touch paper here. Henson. Up to Barnes, leaping beautifully. Aldridge. The goal kick. One goal scored, a fabulous season, John Aldridge, and won each of the last six games. Nicol. Stopped by Winterburn. Here's Richardson. Merson. Crossed in again towards Smith. Ablett got the header in for Liverpool, and a valuable one it was. O'Leary there for Arsenal. This is really competitive again now. Oh, into the path of Barnes from David O'Leary's pass. A foul on Barnes by Thomas. A free kick to Liverpool. Just a constant wall of noise now. Staunton. Whelan. Barnes in a bit of space. In goes Dixon. There's Richardson. Little four for Rowcastle. As Arsenal try to get forward again, they're stopped by Staunton. It'll be a free kick. Minutes are left. O'Leary's free kick. Sizing up the situation. Stephen Bold's in there as well. It's Smith's. And then Nicol. And Grobbelaar eventually grabs it at the second attempt. And a mistake there by Steve Nicol could have cost Liverpool dear. McMahon. Ablett. McMahon. Beardsley. Whelan. Staunton.
You just get the feeling Liverpool are happy to sit on it, and it may be a very unwise policy.
And so unlike them.
Well, whether Arsenal may just run out of steam, Brian, that is another question that we must also consider. They've put a tremendous amount into this half so far.
Merson. Richardson. They really up the tempo, and so far it's paid off with that opening goal from Alan Smith. But Arsenal need another one. Here's Barnes. Comes to Merson. And now Richardson. McMahon, is he running into trouble though? Oof, just flicked it across the face of Rowcastle and found Steve Staunton with it. There's the long one for Aldridge to chase. But here's O'Leary for Arsenal. Adams, getting it on for Winterburn. Liverpool are doing the hustling though. Hansen's header. Richardson now guiding one into the path of Winterburn. Alan Smith. Ablett's there with him. Merson. Richardson. The chance here. Thomas! And Grobbelaar was able to grab it. Suddenly Thomas totally unmarked deep inside the Liverpool penalty area. And what a golden opportunity that was. And Grobbelaar just got down in time.
Liverpool are living on the nerves at the moment. And George Graham will really be proud of the way Arsenal have taken this game to Liverpool in the second half. It's a very difficult ground to play up. They've really played with tremendous passion and drive.
I think Liverpool and Arsenal fans up and down the country are living on their nerves at the moment as well. First division season now beginning to reach an exciting and really dramatic climax. Merson's coming off. And Martin Hayes comes on as Arsenal make a substitute. Well, that Staunton's ball I thought was going to go behind for the goal kick. Barnes from Beardsley's back heel. Knocked away though by Adams. Really furious out there now as Hansen will take his time to play it to Ablett and then back to Grobbelaar. Houghton. Oh, upended there by Richardson. That could well be a yellow card. It is. He really took Houghton out of it then, Kevin Richardson.
First yellow card of the night. Going to Kevin Richardson and providing Liverpool with this free kick. Staunton and Barnes behind it. It's Barnes who plays it in. Bowles header away. Richardson helped it on its way. Here's McMahon for Liverpool. A deft little touch there by him for John Barnes. But Arsenal get it away. O'Leary up to Smith. Beautifully killed by him. And Ablett got in. And Hanson will get it back. Quarter of an hour left. Remember, Arsenal need two goals. At the moment, they have one. If it stays this way, Liverpool will be champions for the 19th time. But will it stay this way? Liverpool slow. To be taken by Reha. Another Liverpool throw, this time by Nicol. Another substitution. Arsenal want to bring on Perry Groves, another attacker. We can't say they're taking Steve Bold off, so a defender's coming off, and Bold's done a good job, not least in fact when he's gone forward to use his height in the air in the Liverpool penalty area. But he's off now, and another striker comes on as Arsenal now play their last card, seeking this vital second goal. It's with McMahon. Beardsley back to McMahon, into the path of Beardsley. The whistle's gone. Arsenal concede another free kick. Liverpool might have preferred to have gone on. And McMahon with an injury to the right leg. David Pleat.
Yeah, he certainly got caught there, McMahon. But he's had great difficulties getting away from people tonight and getting into areas around the box where he can create a clear-cut opening. I do feel that well, he's got caught there. Not a bad one. The three centre-backs dealt very effectively with every aerial ball that came along, and Ball did a very good job. O'Leary, you know, 15, 16 years, has done tremendous service for Arsenal. The three centre-backs have done ever so well tonight.
Oh, that amazing sight. On the clock. But there's still a job to be done. With about 12 minutes left, with Liverpool needing to hold this one goal advantage overall, remembering Arsenal are leading 1-0 on the night, but they need to win by two goals to win the championship. If they don't, then Liverpool take the title. Barnes with a kick, beyond the post, a goal kick. And I think Michael Thomas might be into trouble. There's something he said to the referee. No, it's Rocastle. So Rocastle also gets the yellow card. Free kick to Liverpool. One to Barnes on the far side, well covered by O'Leary. Here's Michael Thomas again, the long ball forward. Martin Hayes chasing for it. Robilar right out of his goal, and a long and quite an effective clearance there. Thomas is in first for Arsenal, who still give the impression of being able to finish the stronger of the two sides, but that's easy for Robilar.
just now maybe a little bit more space for Beardsley and for Aldridge. Without the security of the third centre-back, I just feel they might be able to thread one or two balls through the middle to them, and they might be able to conjure some magic, a little bit of magic, as the legs get tired for Arsenal.
But really, it's a gamble that George Graham had to take in terms of taking off Bold, presumably, and putting on Perry Groves. Liverpool throw, Houghton with it. Nicol winning that battle. The charge is on. Thomas is after him. And a free kick just outside the box. I think the cop were calling for a penalty, but the first shove was clearly outside the Arsenal penalty area. So can Liverpool make it safe now? Can they get the equaliser on the night and retain, or regain rather, that two-goal cushion? A little shove there by Michael Thomas in the first place. Barnes behind it.
You watch Nicol in slow motion and you realise how quick he's going. Tremendous power.
Staunton and Barnes. My money would be on Barnes as the Klopp are playing now for this second goal. Barnes playing it short, getting it back to Houghton. And Rocastle gets it away. Here's Ablett. Into touch by Aldridge. Arsenal throw. Can't let a couple of great footballing birthday celebrations today go unannounced. Sir Matt Busby, 80 today. I hope Sir Matt is watching, of course. Played here at Liverpool, came in about 1936, played a few years here before the Second World War. The father of football, I'm sure the world will send him their warmest congratulations on his 80th birthday. And Stan Mortensen of Blackpool in England, 68 today, so happy birthday to you, Morty. It's with Aldridge, and suddenly Houghton through! Just over the top. And as you were suggesting, as Arsenal press forward and have released that extra defender, so the gaps might start to appear and the possibilities for Liverpool to restore that two-goal lead. Lovely little touch from there from Aldridge for Houghton. Back to Lukic. Liverpool. 7 minutes to go.
Liverpool can comfortably hit the spaces now behind the Arsenal fullbacks.
This really is a nail-biting climax now. Houghton. Richardson got it away. Winterburn crossing it and driven his cross in there towards Rocastle and Grobbelaar. Tension in young eyes and old, as we have a little over 6 minutes left. If Liverpool can hold on, they are the champions, as Arsenal go searching again for that important second goal.
It just shows the significance of those five goals against West Ham.
Dixon kept it in play, found Thomas, found Richardson. On this side is Winterburn, a ball curved into his path. He hopes that Nicol read that well. There are the signals, get forward, get forward. And the time really has come now with 5.5 minutes left for Arsenal to take whatever risks must be taken as they push themselves forward. Play on, says referee Hutchinson. Adams planting it onto the head of Smith, down for Winterburn. Martin Hayes, and now Perry Groves, the other substitute. The ball is crossed in. John Barnes right back there helping out in defence. Beardsley, but Beardsley has only given it to Winterburn. Nicol gets it back to Grobbelaar. Relief amongst the Liverpool fans.
A few more seconds go away and exactly 5 minutes now left in this championship season. Smith, little touch, Rocastle. Charging through but stopped by Hansen. Ironic really that Alan Hansen, who's been such a star for so long, won't qualify for a championship medal. This is only his sixth league game and you have to have 10. A long spill out with injury, but now it's Beardsley. McMahon upping the pace a little bit. Beardsley with a bit of space to move. It'll come to Barnes. Into Aldridge, the flag is up on the far side. So let's leave the clock there now as we come, as you can see, to the last 4 minutes of the game. Everything hanging now on these last 4 minutes. A season of struggle that started in August has come right through here now towards the end of May. All to be decided in the last 4 minutes for the likes of Kenny Dalglish. If his side hold on, they become the champions again. And he becomes the first manager ever to win the double twice. Seconds tick away. Arsenal have a free kick from this sort of position where they scored their crucial goal. Winterburn again will take it, as he did previously. Smith is poised once more as he was to glance the header in. O'Leary is in there too, and Nicol is there to make the clearance, and a valuable one too for Liverpool. It's Arsenal's throw. The clock showing 3 minutes left, plus whatever time David Hutchinson adds on for injuries, of course. Perry Groves with a long throw. Adams was in there. Can Hayes get in there too? Hansen, as cool as you like, just stabs it away. And Houghton is pleased to get it away into the Arsenal half of the field. Still the seconds reel away. Thomas. And Arsenal come forward again to the head of Smith, to Martin Hayes. And Abdon is there just ducking it back with his head of a blah-blah. Just a fraction of a second before Tony Adams got there for Arsenal. Aldridge. Beardsley's through the middle. He's offside though. So Arsenal get the chance to pile another free kick into that Liverpool half. The clock shows 2 minutes to go. Arsenal fans imploring their team, come on you yellows, they want that second important goal. But suddenly the break is on. Beardsley leading the charge. Aldridge in the perfect position on the far side, but Lukic is there. He'll want to get the ball forward quickly. Richardson is down with a leg injury, and he's still down, but Arsenal want to go on. 41,783 is the crowd here at Anfield, and not a soul has left before the final whistle, you can be sure. Treatment for Kevin Richardson. Referee will have to add on time, unless there is an amazing and dramatic twist now. It looks like Liverpool, David.
Yes, I think they've set out. They've been very professional tonight. They've made certain of doing the job. They've defended very well in the second half when Arsenal have powered forward in search of the second goal. Barnes, who probably has been as creative and as brilliant a player for them at times this season, has been mainly defending this half and quite happy to do so. And that will all be worthwhile if in a couple of minutes' time they've won the championship.
Well, there's John Barnes saying, come on, as he shouts to his teammates, John Aldridge over there. Let's just keep it going for a few seconds more. Richardson is down again. He's presumably will have to go off. And remember, Arsenal have both their substitutes already on. 1 minute to go. McMahon has got the word from the cop, obviously. But nobody knows quite how much time the referee will have on. But there's a real competitor. And there's a man who really has earned a championship medal. The faces of the players are something to behold at the moment.
I think in a way, if Arsenal are to lose the championship, having had such a lead at one time, it's somewhat poetic justice that they have got the result on the last day, even though they're not to win it.
They would see that as small consolation, I would think, David, but you can see we're now well into time added on. Just a few seconds away now for Kenny Dalglish. Unless Arsenal can mount something absolutely spectacular in the few seconds that remain. Nichols in there, Barnes is in there, Adams has stopped him. Barnes has beaten Adams. Aldridge is waiting at the far side. Adams is after his man, but Barnes will not be denied. Yes, he will, by Richardson, moment ago, down and injured. Arsenal comes streaming forward now in surely what will be their last attack. A good ball by Dixon, finding Smith. But Thomas charging through the midfield. Thomas, it's up for grabs now. Thomas, right at the end. Unbelievable climax to the league season. Well into injury time, the Liverpool players are down, absolutely abject. Aldridge is down, Barnes is down, Dalglish just stands there. Nichols on his knees, McMahon's on his knees. Suddenly it was Michael Thomas bursting through. The bounce fell his way. He flips it wide of Grobbelaar. And we have the most dramatic finish maybe in the history of the Football League. The top two challenging on the night, and the title possibly decided in the last minute of the whole season. But wait a moment, Whelan turning it in, and Thomas gets it back to Lukic. He played nearly 2 minutes of injury time. George Graham would love to get out there and play himself, and so would Kenny Dalglish. It's agony for them and for the fans, as Liverpool now, for so long it seemed in command, set the final whistle. Arsenal, the champions! A momentous occasion this for Arsenal. Coming here requiring a two-goal lead and snatched it in the most dramatic fashion in the last minute of the game. A hammer blow for Liverpool, for the likes of John Barnes, who over the season have produced football of the most majestic standards. David O'Leary helps Aldridge to his feet, and Aldridge wasn't too happy with that. The Cop bravely and gamely applauding their heroes. But the winners are Arsenal, who've gone across to their fans, and they came, it seemed, without a chance. But the Gunners have kept their powder dry until it really mattered. They've denied Liverpool the League and Cup double. Arsenal then champions for the first time since 1971, the ninth time in their history. The first side to win by two goals here at Anfield since 1986. A superhuman effort against the odds. And achieved with that goal in the last minute by Michael Thomas. We'll take a break.
National and Provincial presents The Next Generation in Banking.
Hello. This is Max, your telebanking computer. You can phone me 24 hours a day. I manage your account. I pay your bills. I even add interest. I also have your money ready at over 1,000 cash machines, day and night.
Max, the cash card account for the next generation.
Call Max. And your money talks.
Searching for oil. Now we can disclose we found it. Satellite pictures of this planet's surface were beamed to Earth, revealing telltale rock formations. Is this the Moon? Mars? Or Saturn? No. It's somewhere much more down to Earth. Finding new energy reserves is one of the things BP is doing today for all our tomorrows.
You're looking sharp, you're looking good, you've come so far. We know how to make the most of who you are. Father's a son, it's what we've always done. Gillette!
The Gillette Contour Plus System. With Lubristrip, for the best a man can get.
Kevin, where exactly did you bury the car?
In the sand! I'm not helping much, am I, Dad?
No, but I know a man who can.
AA 5 Star, an AA travel service. We're all you need to know.
Yes, it could well have sand in the engine, yes.
It all started when Mr. Roberts came home with a new Videomatic camera to number 14. An Amstrad Fidelity production starring Mrs. Roberts.
Ready when you are, Mrs. Amell.
And their mysterious daughter, Mandy.
Oh, I hate being filmed.
Ronnie Roberts as the midfield general.
Great.
And introducing the happy feet of young Jennifer Roberts. Gasp at the amazing costumes.
I'll just wait till we're on holiday.
And laugh at it all instantly on the privacy of your own TV.
The Videomatic from Amstrad Fidelity. The whole shooting match for just £499.
Well, welcome back. Absolutely incredible scenes here at Anfield. Arsenal are the champions. They needed to win by 2-0 here this evening, or by 2 clear goals, and they did just that. I've never seen anything quite like it, Bobby Robson. Very briefly, a reaction?
Well, football never surprises you, does it? It happens all the time. An incredible performance by Arsenal. Marvellous for Liverpool, really, because they've had such a wonderful year. But well done for George Graham.
Thanks, Bobby. Let's join Jim Rosenthal down on the pitch.
Well, down here on the centre of the pitch, Tony Adams is lined up on my right with a huge grin on his face. Arsenal have done what many people think was an impossible task. They've won here 2-0 tonight. They've got the championship. And Tony Adams is about to be the proudest footballer in Britain, I would think, if not in Europe. And about to come forward and receive the trophy from John Quinton, the chairman of Barclays Bank. Tony, old chap, through you go. And great credit as well to the Anfield fans. Well done. I mean, everybody said it was impossible here tonight, but you kept going until the 91st minute.
Yeah, that's the way it goes. We had that bit of luck tonight, didn't we? We got the late goal, and there's no way they was going to come back scoring that late. You know, the lads were really fired up, and I'm very pleased, and the boys have magnificent, played brilliant.
But deep down here, be honest, driving up on the coach, should you really have that inner feeling that Arsenal could do it?
You know, coming up here and playing at Liverpool, you know, it's a very hard place to come on any situation. So we just give it a go. We just give it our best shot, and it worked out for us on the night. You know, you can only do your best, and we tried hard and done our best.
Many congratulations to you and to Arsenal.
Thank you very much, Jim. Thank you.
Well, absolutely astonishing, Bobby. I think we both agree. You've been watching football a lot longer than me. I think neither of us seen anything quite like the scenes here at Anfield this season. It marks the end of our series of the match this season. We hope you've all enjoyed it. From the two of us tonight, bye-bye.
Bank Holiday Monday at 8. Superman faces three evil adversaries from the planet Krypton intent on destroying the world.
These people have such powers, nothing can stop them.
Where's Superman?
He has a few personal dilemmas of his own.
Well, it seems kind of strange to me that every time Superman's around, you disappear.
Faced with powers equal to his own, has Superman met his match?